EA Sports, it's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch them run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk.
From the site that many call the loudest in the NFL, we are inside GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City.
The scene just a few moments ago, predictably loud and raucous here at Arrowhead as their beloved Chiefs took field, and they are set to match up with the Washington football team. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Arrowhead.
DeAndre Carter now from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. A run here for J.D. McKissic.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. A carry now for McKissic. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Derek Nnadi makes the tackle.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carry.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Juan Thornhill. And the Chiefs are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive.
He's just got to be thinking, I hope that's not a harbinger of things to come. Very first pass of the afternoon picked.
And where do you go from here? Because when you start that way, do you allow that to seep into you and stay with you the rest of the game? Or do you find a way out of it? We're going to find out.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. The 20.
And he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown.
We constantly talk about defenders having great vision and being able to see plays unfold and make their own plays, but you also have to have good feel as well, because you can't see everything out there. See the play unfold, feel what's going on, and then get into the right spot and make your own play. And in this case, it turned out to be a highlight one.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded right around the eight. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last. It got his man complete. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Travis Kelce, 79 yards. And the Chiefs have tied it, and they can take the lead with the extra point. Extra point by Butker is on target, and they take the lead here at 7-6. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Oh, trying to gauge the sun, and he muffs it. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake.
A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead is up to eight. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. A fairly short kick from the 14. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount, here's his opportunity.
It all comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. Yeah. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? Yeah. Now this will go for five up to the 33.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Third and short yardage, Fitzpatrick. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. He's at the 30. 10, 5, touchdown, Washington. Curtis Samuel, 67 yards. And Washington now within a two-point conversion of tying this game. This time, the extra point up and good. And this is now a one-point game. 14, Washington 13. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, we'll see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's
true. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Hey, we got three down.
To throw once more on second and 10. Mahomes flush to his right. And Mahomes picking up the first as he slides and hits the deck.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On first down, Mahomes. They'll set up the screen to Edwards-Helaire. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception, and that means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
They'll run for the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And a short gain down to about the 33. An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports. Working from the gun, Mahomes. He'll look underneath here for Edwards-Helaire. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. Eluding the Mahomes hit. He lost the football. And it's Washington that scoops it up. And this one will be brought back to the 22. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and 4.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play? Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
Fitzpatrick on 3rd and 2. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
They'll go. It's Gibson, and nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped behind the line. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. Mahomes now on 1st down. Going down the middle, and it's complete. Touchdown! Byron Pringle, 27 yards. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. So that pretty conclusively, I might add, shows you the perils of going for it and not making it on fourth down. One play, touchdown.
Yeah, and I've got to put this on the man in charge, the head coach. He made the decision to go for it. To me, when punting was the only decision to make, and it backfired on him in a big way.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for me.
He's got a man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A big play that time through the air. 35 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Fitzpatrick slings this deep for McLaurin. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin. 38 yards. And Washington now within a two-point conversion of tying this game. A little surprising they wouldn't go for two, but this is up and good. And this is now a one-point game. Washington 20. Joey Sly sets to kick off. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Certainly not what they wanted there, so the football by rule comes out to the 40.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Mahomes gonna throw. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
They fake the give. Now Mahomes on the move to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Catch is made by Hardman. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. Steps away to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. And able to work his way down to the 16. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire, a 16-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead is up to 8. Washington. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Carter. And he returns this to the 22. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts,
as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Off the play fake to Gibson. Fitzpatrick. And the Chiefs are going to get him. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16.
Another try after the first down sack. Fitzpatrick, he's going to launch this thing way downfield. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Mike Hughes.
And the Chiefs are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there, you throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
Forced out to his left.
That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire.
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. They spot it on the midfield stripe, so it is a 60-yard attempt here.
Butker's kick here is good, and that will do it for this first half.
That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football.
Hill is going to take it out of the end zone.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, Chiefs.
And people still trying to get back to their seats from the concession stand here at the start of the third quarter. And boom, we got points on the board.
And you just identified why the bulk of stadiums have increased presence in the concession areas, right? TVs, loudspeakers, so people can still follow the game. And right now, they're bummed out that they missed that big return to start this half.
Butker on for the PAT. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw.
From his end zone, here comes Carter. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. The delay of game backs them up 5, first and 15. Fitzpatrick going to give to Gibson. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup. Only needing 2 yards on second down. Once more, Gibson.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Come on, D. Strong. Strip the ball. Strip that ball. Mike's 50. Bring it. Mike's 50.
Fitzpatrick on first down. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today.
Did all that to throw a pick.
And the Chiefs will take over possession here up at the 44. First possession of the 3rd quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
From midfield, here's Mahomes. Dancing to his left. And Mahomes picking up the first as he slides and hits the deck.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
That's caught left side by Hardman, and they'll have it in the red zone.
Yeah, goodbye. Absolutely not. No, you should be embarrassed.
Before he crosses over out of bounds. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Now Edwards-Helaire. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They'll run with Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. 2 of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on 2nd and goal. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. Travis Kelce. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run, and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
And that'll set him back five. They'll try it again now after the 5-yard walk-off. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Juan Thornhill. And a great
you gonna leave now?
He gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean,
it's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent. But a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ball game, I would have said never, not in a million years.
It's like every single time I talk to you, something messes up and I get a grieving. You're funny.
Play clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. That's going to set him back 5 yards. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line.
Not the kind of gain that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of gain. That you need to have when you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength. He's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
So still 14 yards to go, second down. Throwing now is Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Here's Mahomes to throw. Flushed out right. And Mahomes picking up the first as he slides and hits the deck. 3 quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw, it's Mahomes. Flush to his right. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down. They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. 8 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Chiefs just continue to pour it on. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that will extend this big lead. Ooh, a little cruel here. They're going to go for the onside kick up big. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down.
So they hit the ball before it went 10 yards. I know that's tough, but you got to stay disciplined.
It is difficult because you're so eager to go get the football. It's that type of a play, but you're exactly right. Have to have the discipline to let it go 10 first.
On play action, Fitzpatrick. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Mike's 50. He'll kill. Get him.
Throwing Fitzpatrick. That one caught by Gibson. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming. To throw, Fitzpatrick. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now fourth down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But two, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
And now here is another interception. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And the Chiefs are going to take over at their own 41. CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're...
Benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz the 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The lying to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chopped it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was your business for me.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Bill Stadium in upstate New York. The folks in Buffalo love their Bills, and a moment ago, they entered to the delight of this sold-out crowd. They're set for football as their Bills will do battle with the New Orleans Saints. And we are underway in Buffalo. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
Hey, buddy, too late. 54, right? 54. They can't hang with
it. Stop.
Kamara's got the first down and then some. And all the way down to the 12. 63 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Alvin Kamara.
A 12-yard touchdown run. And the Saints take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Lutz good on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off.
From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie.
And the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 21. Throwing to start the drive. Allen eluding the pressure right. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big gain there for the Bills. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. From the gun, it's Allen. Escaping the pressure right. And Allen will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact at the end. Throwing on first down is Allen. Flushed out right. Allen hit. He lost the football. The Saints say they have it, and they do. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
Play fake. Winston. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Winston to give, it's Kamara. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. They go play action. Winston. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there at the moment the ball gets to the receiver. And he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
On third down, Winston.
He'll find his tight end. It's Adam Trautman.
And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 40. Winston. He gets this one complete to Traquan Smith. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. A give. This is Kamara. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. First down, Winston.
He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. There he goes, left side.
One play at a time. Here
and
we go.
He is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. Well, that's going to change the course of things. They had a good drive work and a chance to really open things up here in the first quarter. Instead, the defense, they got exactly what they needed.
Yeah, they certainly did, because making that type of a play gives them confidence moving forward and maybe makes them a little more reticent on the offensive side of the ball.
Because if the touchdown had gone the other way, this thing could have started to get ugly early. The extra point by Bass, up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did.
Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Levi Wallace with a pick. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Tyler Bass now for the point after. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive.
And oh, Jameis intercepted a 3rd time. It's A.J. Klein, the linebacker. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's 2nd down. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10.
Quit talking about it and bring it.
A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. Flush to his right. Allen hit. He lost the football. The Saints say they have it, and they do.
Okay, after those first two drives, I think there's a head coach who's going to be calling for CSI. They're going to want some forensics on this. What is going on with this ball club unable to hold on to the football and take care of it?
Yeah, 2 straight fumbles for them to start out.
Yeah, you would think that this team would come in ready to go. Sometimes just mentally not prepared, and it shows up in these types of plays.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time wasn't pretty. 1 play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 89 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half. From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another 1st and 10. Now a handoff. Here's Kamara. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker, was the one disrupting there defensively. After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
But you've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
He's going to have his running back. It's complete. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. From the gun, Winston. That is caught by Callaway. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. They give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal. They'll run it with Kamara. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down. Final play of the half here, Winston. That is caught, Traquan Smith. Touchdown, Saints. Traquan Smith, as time expires in the first half. And the Saints have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. And oh, he missed it. No good. And they'll remain down by a point. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. Bills with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. McKenzie now from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, if there were 3 talking points at the half, partner, all of them were about turnovers because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they...
And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Cameron Jordan, give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Mike 56. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Cole Beasley, 88 yards. And the Bills will extend their lead. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead is up to 8. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now Winston completes this to Callaway over on the right side. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Off the play fake. Winston. To the sideline, and it's caught, but boy, he's out of bounds. Now they tried to get him into space coming out of the backfield, but it'll be third down.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. On play action, Winston. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills, right?